And we started last week in the book of Ephesians, chapter 5. And this is what the Lord put on my heart to share with the young people, the children, the women and the men of this church. And I struggled with the second pericope, or the second passage in this chapter. And I realized that I had to depend completely on God to figure out something, because I am also guilty of everything this chapter talked about. This morning I'm asking you to give me less than 15 minutes of your time, of your attention. Children, old people, allow the Holy Spirit less than 15 minutes of your time now to see if God can speak with you and can speak with me through His Word. And in this chapter, as moral people with common sense, we don't have to get involved in bad things. As Christians who want to imitate God and follow Christ, we don't have to engage ourselves in immoral and illegal activities. Well, the Christian at Ephesus, they also knew that. And yet, the writer of Ephesians felt that it was important to remind them not to do immoral acts that were obvious not to do. Acts like sexual relationships outside of marriage commitments, lust, adultery, the use of profanities, stealing, cursing, dirty and nasty behaviors, hypocrisy, bad-mouthing each other, lying, selfish, greed, borrowing and not paying back, the refusal to share, stinginess, mean acts, etc. must not exist among them. These acts are addictive behavior that even the newly converts know not to get involved in. Well, the reason why they had to avoid those acts was because that now they were considered as saints to Jesus Christ. In Ephesians 5 verses 3 to 5, He asked them to renounce the old lifestyle that they used to live before they had met with Christ. And this morning I'm going to ask you to open your Bible with me in this letter, Ephesians chapter 5. And we will read only two verses. Three verses. 3, 4, and 5. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 3, 4, and 5. Give me your attention, please. I won't be long. Less than 15 minutes, I'm out of here. And it reads, "But fornication or impurity of any kind or greed must not even be mentioned among you, as is proper among saints." Underline the word saints. As is proper among saints. Anybody can say this with me? As is proper among saints. And it says, and these are entirely out of place, obscene, silly, vulgar talk. But instead, let there be thanksgiving. Be sure of this, that no fornicator or impure person or one who's greedy, that is, an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. If you walk out of this church this morning and you forget anything that was in the sermon, remember this. Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. We are saints. Thanks be to Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. We are saints. Why did the writer take the time to remind the Ephesians not to do those things? Maybe it's because he understood that they had a sinful nature in them. The Bible is clear on that. We were made in the image of God. Unfortunately, Satan tried to sabotage the creation of God. Our first parents listened to the voice of the serpent in the Garden of Eden, and they disobeyed God. Since that time, you and I, we have been doing the exact things that we do not want to do. When we are driving, we know not to take a red light. We know not to speed on the road so that we can be safe. Yet if there is no police officer around, we still do. We know that as good children, we must not lie to our parents. Yet if we think that we will not be caught
we still lie.
We don't have to talk bad about others because we would not want anyone to talk bad about us either.
Yet if we think that they will not know, we still don't know.
Because they already know that sweet stuff are bad for them. Yet they still crave and consume them in spite of the consequences. We know that we overweight sometimes and we must take care of our bodies. Yet we still eat a large pizza and drink a Diet Coke late at night and go straight to bed. We know that physical exercise is good for us. Yet we don't feel like going to the gym. We know that we must go to school in order to learn a profession so that we can have a better financial future. Yet we feel that it takes too long to get a college degree. We know that we must read our Bible and pray every day so that we can grow up. Yet we still come up with all sorts of excuses why we don't. We know that we need to keep good communication with our wives, husbands, children, in order to have a harmonious family. Yet we let work and fatigue take over us. And the list goes on and on. We have fallen into a constant struggle to stay in communion with God, with each other, and even with our own self. And it's not the Romans, Paul warned how hard the struggle to please God would have been for the Christians if they had to remain under the law. And he says, in Romans 7, verses 17 to 21, he told them, "As it is no longer I myself who do bad things, but it is sin living in me. For I know that good itself does not dwell in me, that is, in my sinful nature, for I have the desire to do what is good, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want to do, but the evil I do not want to do. This I keep on doing. Now, if I do what I do not want to do, it is sin living in me that is it, that does it." So, I find that this law is at work in me. Although I want to do good things, evil is right there with me. For in my inner being, I want to respect God's law, but I see not a law at work in me, fighting against the law of my mind and making me a prisoner of the law of sin at work in me. What a messed up man I am. Who will rescue me of this body that is subject to death? But he said, "Thanks be to God who delivers me through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then, myself in my mind, I'm a slave to God's law. But in my sinful nature, I'm a slave to the law of sin." My brothers and sisters, I would like to proclaim to you this morning, if you're struggling against any one of these strongholds in your life, you are not alone. Most of us are struggling with at least one of them. If we don't lie, we cheat. If we don't curse, we are hypocrites. The first step in winning the battle against those impure things is to acknowledge and recognize their presence in our lives and submit ourselves completely to God so that the Holy Spirit can be the only spirit that fills our entire body. We must not become comfortable with them. That is the reason why the Bible reminds us not to let them be even named among us, because we are saints. It is not because we are strong Christians that we will not do bad things, but it is because of our total dependency upon the grace of God that sanctifies us. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 45, Jesus instructs us, "Be perfect as our Father in heaven is perfect." For his part, the writer of 1 Peter 1, verse 15, he left us a message. And he told us, "Just as who calls us is holy, so we also must be holy in all we do." Is this a goal that we can achieve by our own strength? Can we ever become perfect just like our Father in heaven is perfect? The answer to this question is in spending time in thanksgiving. It is in our total dependency upon the Holy Spirit. It is in our constant effort to imitate God, our beloved children. It is in doing all we can
in order to present ourselves as a fragrant offering before God. In Romans 5, verses 19 to 21, it says, "For as by one man disobedience many were made sinners, so also by one man's obedience many will be made righteous. Moreover, when offenses abound, grace abound much more. So that it is sent as sin brought death, even so grace might bring righteousness to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." Thanks be to God, through Jesus Christ, we are saints. Although it might be hard to live a perfect life like our Father in heaven, thanks be through Jesus Christ, we are saints. Although it might be hard to be holy like our Father in heaven is holy, thanks be to Jesus Christ, we are saints. Although we struggle against strongholds that should not even name among us, but thanks be to Jesus Christ, we are saints. No matter the challenges we are going through in our spiritual life, let us remember to keep up our thanksgiving. Let us remember not to let a few things be even named among us. Let us fight to get our inheritance in the kingdom of God. Because thanks be to God through Jesus Christ, we are saints. May God bless his people this morning. Amen.